How you doing, everybody? Randy Richard in the shop. This is the second part of building the base, and we're going to try to see how far we can get here, but we'll do a few features. We're going to do the holes in the end and the side profile. We're going to save the porting and the lettering for the last one because they're a lot more advanced and maybe a little more complicated. So let's do the end profile here. We've already got all our bosses and bores done. So we're going to, again, we're going to right click on that surface and create sketch. Now we're going to turn on, in sketch one, we had a reference line. We're going to turn sketch one back on. And now that line appears. And that line indicates where the bores go for these ports. So we're going to go C for circle. We're going to get on, we zoom in maybe a little bit, and we're going to catch that line. Where are we? And it's 0.213. Now, this is a note. I drilled these and tapped them a quarter 28. And if you're sitting here and you have a smartphone, I use an app called iEngineer on my phone, and it's great. It has all your drill charts, fractional charts, and metric screws and US screws and bolts and sizes and tap sizes, all tons of information. So I can just look up some of that information right away, and I know what size hole to put in. And so that really helps an awful lot. Now we'll dimension this. Now this from the top is 0.278, and it here to the side should be 0.225. I must have still not been on it. Anyway, we have one other hole, and we're going to come off of this hole down 0.213. And the dimension from here to here is 0.644. So we've placed them. There's some constraints that have been added by Fusion. You see, they stop sketch. We can turn that other one off. We'll do Q, press pull. And we can select both of those at once and drag them. And if you turn it sideways, you can see where you're going. And that looks about good. An inch and a half is a nice, easy number. And it's a cut. We'll say OK. Now we have bores. Now these are threaded. So we're going to go up here, create, and we'll do thread. We're going to select that. Hold your control key down and select them both. We're not going to go full length thread, so we'll turn that off. We'll just go in 0.4 inches, nice even number. And type of thread, unified screw thread. Size ranges, it's going to be a quarter inch. And we don't want quarter 20, we want quarter 28. See all the choices you have. And then well, we just designation is quarter 28, and class B is fine, right hand is fine, and we're good. And we're not going to model it. If you model the thread here, it looks like a picture, right? You know, if you model it, it actually draws it in there, and it's very hard to select if you want to use it as a referencing, if you want to use that circle or hole as a reference. If you model it, it's hard to select the center. So I just leave it as non-modeled. Turn off our other sketches here. So there we got our two ports in. Now let's do the side feature, the contours for the sides. So we're just going to right click on that surface again, create sketch. Now, so the sketch has a scallop and a and a scallop and a radius. So we're just going to draw some circles in here. I don't care what size they are. I don't care really their location or anything. I'm just going to draw some. That one I'll make 3/4, I think. And with this another one down here, we'll make that one 1/2 inch. Whoops. Okay, I made it 5 inches. Make it 0.5. There. Now we're going to use a constraint over here called tangent. Click on that, and I want this circle to be tangent to that. I want this circle to be tangent to that. There, see, it adjusts it to the size we need. We want this circle to be tangent to this. We want this circle to be tangent to that. I want this circle to be tangent to this. And let's see here. I'm just going to drag this one down a little closer. Sometimes if they're far apart here, but we'll just do this, right? And I want this circle to be tangent with this. There. Now they're connected together, and I can just drag that down to wherever I want, right? And probably somewhere. We can make it so that these are all in line with that circle, with this one. So we'll just say dimension that to here. Let's say it's 1.5. And this one, let's do the same with this one. There. There we go. Now we got our lines. Now we're going to make this all connected for the part. We're going to cut away all this stuff. So we're just going to draw some straight lines just to make sure we have everything. And we're just going to go outside. And something like that. Pretty close. Let's see, we'll make this corner perpendicular with that, something like that. I think we're pretty good. And then now we're going to use the trim command. We're going to get rid of the stuff we don't need. We don't need the one that goes up there. We don't need this. We don't need this. All those little bits. We don't need this. Now I think we have a nice pink area, and if you hold it here, oh, we have something in there we don't need, right? We want this cut away, so we forgot that little bit. Trim that. There. Now we have a nice blue section that we can cut away. It looks pretty good. Now, let's see. Yeah. So we're just going to go in here and end the sketch. Q, select, cut it to this side, simple, done. Hey, there we go. There's the profiling and our end ports. All right, we'll save the last couple parts for the final little video in this series of engine porting, lettering, and making it some nice fancy colors. Thanks, you guys, and thanks for watching.